Lazortrons are in the trader right now. They've been buffed since the last time they were out, and they're actually really good right now. I bought one day of it to try it out, and I'm definitely gonna buy all the rest. I'm probably gonna try to wait till this tribe cycle's over, though. I'll walk you through two attacks I had today, both on 7 boosted ice. This meta layout with the two shock blasters in the back, this is a really... My mind was blown when I saw how well this works. So I haven't checked the stats exactly, but they have to do more damage to the things in the back than the things up front, because these sniper towers have less health than the boom cannons, and definitely less than the shock launchers. But these Lazortrons actually take out all 8 of those buildings that they're hitting, and the snipers go last, so it must be like they do more damage the further away something is, or something to that effect. So they outrange snipers by a little bit. So you can drop them when snipers are up front and clear basically everything behind them. One medic boat to heal from that rocket to keep them alive, because their health is not the best. And you take down 2 boom cannons, 2 cannons, 2 snipers, 2 shock launchers, and then after that, another rocket and a sniper. And the base is so open after this, and you farm up extra GB along the way. I'll speed it up a little bit. I'm about to drop troops for the end of the attack. I cut 1 rifle boat and 1 Zuka boat to afford this. I'll go back to 1x speed now. So I have 2 rifles, 2 Zukas, 1 cryo, 1 medic, and 2 Lazortrons. I'm not sure how that'll change with different layouts, but for this one that I'm showing you guys today, this is what I think is most effective. I did let this one get killed, which changed my attack a bit. Flare over to the right, and I think this was not the cleaner of the two attacks, and I shocked kind of early here to try to keep my troops alive, because you do have a much lower total number of troops, and RZCM is all about the critical mass of everything. So you want to keep them alive as long as possible, the ones you still have, and you should be able to farm up a decent amount of GBE from those Lazortrons clearing everything up front. This guy had 3 damage statues. Interesting thing to note. At the tail end here, I shot the shock blaster, waited for that machine gun to go down, and then flared it, and I realized my troops count was kind of low. And my GBE was also a little bit low. And the big thing is I only had 1 Lazortron left. My next strategy is different, and that's because both stayed alive. But since I only had 1 left, I decided to flare up to the top wall and clear over to the shield generator. I had a decent amount of GBE, I guess, not like that low. So I had 2 shocks, I think. Universal moted the flamethrower up top and then shocked the other things to keep those troops alive. Zukas are so much faster at clearing shields than Grens are, and I've been using Grens so much, it's really silly. One more shock on that shock blaster, and I wanted to clear that as soon as the flamethrower was down. The shock blaster is the priority, but I can't walk through splash damage and let it come out of shock and then roast everything. So once that's down, flare the shock blaster. A lot of troops got killed by this machine gun, and I was late on my reflare and lost a few more, and so I barely got the rest of this base down, but finally was able to make it for a free snipe, nothing else in range, able to finish off this HQ with maybe 15 or 20 seconds left on the clock. I really like this attack. The Lazortrons clearing everything makes it so easy. Then one more following that up immediately. This is a very similar base, a couple key differences, but you can still clear snipers, boom cannons, shock launchers, all with the 2 Lazortrons up front. I'll go 4x speed because I realized last time I was talking in 1x speed. So sorry about that. Clear all that stuff. You can get the cannons too, it looks like. That's pretty cool. And then clear that rocket. I did, I think, lose a few troops to this rocket right out of the gates because I dropped them a bit early. Ooh, there we go, back to 1x speed. So this mortar hit, and then the rocket turns and kills the things that had a sliver of health left. This guy only has 2 damage, and my troops had like 1 health left, and the rocket killed them. But anyway, it's all good. I like this approach better. I threw an extra critter box here to distract that mortar, and I didn't need to shock it at all because of that. I saved it to shock the shock blaster and the rocket because I think those overall put in more work, especially if you can distract that mortar with the critters. So take that for what it's worth. A couple medics got trapped on the beach here. Eventually they'll catch up. So medkit on that flamethrower, one more shock on the shock blaster. I still want to clear this machine gun before I flare, but this time I'm going to throw a critter box instead of a shock, and I also like that choice overall. As soon as the machine gun goes down, I will do the same and flare that shock blaster. The difference with these attacks, though, is since I still had both my Lazortrons and a decent number of troops, I decided to reflare back and let the Lazortrons take out this far shock blaster. My Zookas and Riflemen would be in range, but the Lazortrons would shoot straight through the HQ and start pounding away at that shock blaster. I had two shocks left still, so I was pretty sure I'd be okay, and especially with the passive critters, you're able to do a decent amount. Maybe I just had one shock. Yeah, anyway, with the passive critters, you're still able to hold off for quite a while, and those Lazortrons take that shock blaster out so quickly with how far away it is. And once that's down, nothing else is really left. I think that the Lazortrons also have a bit of a splash radius with their laser. Like, they're not going directly over stuff and it's still getting damaged. So I'm not totally sure how these work yet, but they are a lot stronger. And I highly recommend that you give them a try if you haven't yet, because before they were totally useless and now they are really, really great at the special little niche type of hits that you can do with them. Hope you guys enjoy this and you get some time spent with these Lazortrons destroying stuff. Just don't run out of GBE, because the first time I loaded these, I loaded like six of them and clicked attack, and then I was like, oh yeah, that's right, they cost 18 to deploy. Anyway, I'll catch you guys next time. Until then, my name is Ryan. This is the PSC Life. Happy booming.